that's certainly, I need to say, tell you the truth, but I got to agree with you on FDR Boulevard. We've been here, at least two of us have been here 9 years. And we started that process when we first came on board, after we found out that it was a vision was back in the mid-70s to do this boulevard. And it's taken a lot of traffic off of 235. It was envisioned at first that time that it would take 10,000 cars off of 235 a day. It didn't make common sense to do it. I'm sorry it's taken so long. It's 9 years. And like I said, we'll be lucky to get it finished in our 12-year time period that Commissioner Hewitt and I are here. But it's just it's a process that I've learned takes a long time. The acquisition of properties, it's all that dealing we have to do with the local people and their property to get this done. So it's been a real trip. But it's getting done, and I'm looking forward to it being completed. I also want to put a hand out to some of our prophets. So much St. Mary's Caring, the number of meals they put out is unbelievable. And I'm amazed myself that many people show up, like 12,000 meals a year they serve or something. That is unbelievable that they do what they do. And we need to support them best we can. They depend on charities and businesses that donate to them all the time. Talking about volunteerism, we are coming up again for our boards and commissions in the county. We do this every July and December. Please go online. If you want to volunteer, you've probably already seen an advertisement. Sign yourself up. Give us a good resume so we can make a decision and fill these boards. It's important that we have them all filled with the number of people that's required to do their job. They're more or less our eyes and ears out there for the community. And give feedback to the commissioners on things that need to be done. Last but not least, great thing. Last week we had a trip to North Carolina again by my son and daughter-in-law and our new grandson, Theo. He is doing well. He's done so well that when this poor thing was born, they had to put tubes down into his lungs, tubes down into his stomach, IVs all over him. Because he couldn't even breathe on his own when he was born. He had to be forced air. And Saturday morning, they took the CPAC off of him finally. And that's this tubular thing that forces air into him. Now he's just got a minor tube for oxygen still feeding to him, but he's actually breathing very well on his own. And I'm amazed at the care that this hospital down in Wilmington does. I'm amazed at the number of small children that are born like that. He was born 3 months premature. He only weighed 1 pound, 11 ounce when he was born. Now he weighs 4 pounds, 12 ounces. Unbelievable growth. And we finally got a chance to see his eyes for the first time fully open because he couldn't open them up fully with that CPAC on. And now we can. It's an amazing, fine looking young man. Of course, I'm bragging a little bit too. But he is, and he's doing well. And I think all those that did pray for him, I think that helped out a lot. You got to have that hope and God intervention sometimes, because there's actually, as of Tuesday, there are 43 other babies just like him in this one center that are going through this unbelievable care. So thank you all very much for thinking about that.